System of a Down broke onto the scene with their unique blend of rock, metal, and avant-garde folk that propelled these US-based Armenians into a category of their own. Their sophomore release, Toxicity, not only solidified their position musically and politically, but continues to be a reveled release in metal 20 years later. Today, we're looking at 20 facts about System of a Down's Toxicity you may not know. Number 1. Bounce was originally about pajamas. Despite being featured in The Secret Life of Pets for a split second, Bounce is probably the last song you'd call family-friendly. Even though the song itself was supposedly inspired by orgies, the original lyrics were supposed to be a joke song about pajamas before Serge took things in a different direction. Number 2. The album was much longer at first. Most of Toxicity tends to be pretty compact, since the 14 tracks only come down to just short of 45 minutes. This wasn't originally the plan, with Darren and Serge writing almost 32 songs before sorting through them and picking the best of the bunch. You can find many of these leftovers on the surprise release Steal This Album that popped into our lives later the same year. Number 3. Cleaning Up Chop Suey. Once you got a hold of what Serge was saying in Chop Suey, it clearly became a very different tune than the upbeat nature would have you believe. Before it was given its delicious title, it was originally known as Suicide, which was quickly turned down during the final sessions. Number 4. Serge was writing poetry on the side. Although Serge Tankian releases come much slower these days, he was one prolific dude during the Toxicity sessions. Aside from System of a Down releases, Serge released a book around the same time of his poetry entitled Cool Gardens. For any diehard System fans, this is a must-read to get into Serge's head. Number 5. Ariel's Hidden Track. On the back end of Ariel's, there's a hidden track titled Arto that was created by an Armenian street performer named Arto Tunkboyasyan, who Serge befriended when he was taking a break during recording. These final few minutes of the album is also one of the only System of a Down songs without any guitar, instead using chanting and traditional Armenian instruments. Number 6. We're Rolling Suicide. As previously mentioned, the original title to Chop Suey was less than favorable to the label, but even during the recording sessions it became questionable. As you can hear the engineer mumble, "We're Rolling Suicide" before the classic opening guitar riff comes in. Number 7. 9/11 Backlash. With Toxicity being released days before the tragic events of 9/11, it became difficult to continue promotion after the fact. Chop Suey was blacklisted and taken off the radio in response to the line about angels deserving to die. Despite the lack of radio promotion, it didn't stop the album from becoming a hit. Number 8. They didn't know how people would respond. Serge has gone on record that he didn't know if Toxicity was going to connect with their existing fans from the debut album, considering the new direction. Looking back, he thought the idea of a far-left leaning rock record didn't stand a chance on mainstream radio either. Number 9. Darren had to step out of the situation. After years of being the System of a Down captain, Darren admits to stepping out of the sessions when it came time to pick the songs. Since he had a big hand in writing all of them, he figured that he would be too biased as to which songs would make it to the final release. Number 10. It Began in an RV. While many bands would take at least a few weeks before record cycles, Darren began the writing process for Toxicity in the back of their RV while wrapping up their tour for the self-titled record. Number 11. Chop Suey Music Video. Despite most of the video being a staple performance clip, it also contains oddly moving close-up shots that can leave you feeling drunk. This was achieved by the band wearing camera holsters on their bodies, a Hollywood tactic called Snoracam. This trick was especially popularized by Darren Aronofsky films, including his smash hit Requiem for a Dream in 2000. Number 12. Record Release Riot. During the initial record release party, the massive amount of System fans showing up led to a near riot before the band could even perform. By the end of the night, System were absolutely furious, as news reports tried to blame the senseless violence on the band inciting danger. Number 13. Metallica Were Big Fans. It's always nice to hear about bands supporting each other, but System managed to get high praise from one of the all-time greats. At the time, Lars Ulrich and Kirk Hammett were both huge System of a Down fans, and have both gone on to rank this album and songs like Chop Suey as some of their favorite songs of the 2000s. Number 14. More Than Just Metal. Instead of the usual heavy metal of the time, Darren admitted that he was heavily influenced by the Beatles' approach to songwriting on the project. It's not hard to find on the record, considering that the backing tracks of these songs feature everything from piano to string accompaniment throughout the whole thing. Number 15. Rick Rubin took a back seat. If you're an up-and-coming band, having a super producer like Rick Rubin at your disposal is considered an ideal way of refining your sound. According to the album sessions, though, Rick was more of an advisor on the project than a producer, approaching the whole thing from a fan's perspective and tweaking subtle issues here and there. Number 16. Importance of the joke songs. Between all the social commentary found on this record, there comes moments of breaks that are needed for the listener. When talking about the album later, Serj has stressed the importance of the joke songs to give a bit of levity from the heavier topics. This enables a full session of listening to the album, rather than constant skipping. Number 17. Deer Dance Staples Center Coincidence. There's seemingly more to the lyrics of Deer Dance than we originally thought upon first listening. Coincidentally, the song makes mentions of fans at the Staples Center opening themselves up to the plastic of America. Not long after the release, Rage Against the Machine show at the Staples Center ended with fans being sprayed with rubber bullets. A strange coincidence. Number 18. Axis of Justice Genesis. Concurrently with the album sessions and his poetry book, Serj Tankian was also hard at work with Tom Morello creating the Axis of Justice project, inspired by the Nazi regalia that began turning up at some festivals. This was a non-profit organization meant to bring together musicians to stand up against social injustice. Number 19. Aerials wasn't supposed to be a single. System never considered releasing Aerials on its own until it was suggested to them by their label. According to Darren, the song was definitely good, but he didn't think the weird aura of the song would fit with rock radio at the time. Sometimes the suits are right. Number 20. Grammy performance. Most bands would jump at the chance to perform on a televised event, especially one like the Grammys. But when System of a Down received the opportunity to play Aerials on the show, they politely declined. As Serj tells it, he didn't want to put their music alongside the more bubblegum pop that was coming out at the time, like NSYNC and Britney Spears. What's your favorite fact about the album? Let us know in the comments. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more updates.